Mr. Pilsen, afternoon. Before we get talking on the markets, just wanted your view on Reliance and how you're poised into going into its earnings tomorrow.
See, again, you know, because the gross refining margins are likely to fall, because if you really see the Singapore benchmark, it has shown a decline of about 30% on a sequential basis. If you take a call on a YOY, yes, there is going to be the good upside seen in the stock because of the low base for the Q1 of FY13, but I don't think that will really be to take a call. In fact, it will be more logical to see the QOQ performance of the company, which is likely to show a decline, largely because the GRM I am estimating is at about $7.9 per barrel. They had $10.1 per barrel for the preceding quarter, that is Q4 or FY13, but this quarter it is likely to fall to $7.9 per barrel. Petchem performances are likely to be, you know, slightly better because of the currency gain they will be making on, because the product prices, whether you talk of polyester or polymer, are always derived on the import parity prices.
And Mr. Tulsian, what have you made of the Axis Bank numbers and what we've spoken about up till now?
See, Ekta, I like the number. In fact, I think that these numbers will really be liked by the market, and as you have rightly said, the people have been talking of one account getting sticky, the share of which is in fact continuously hitting upper lower circuit for last about couple of weeks or so. So market was very apprehensive that probably the provision is going to get made in the accounts of that. I don't know whether that has been done or that has been deferred, but yes, if I just focus on the Q1 numbers, I won't be removing that hanging sword from the Axis Bank. But if I just focus on Q1 numbers, then yes, things are really good, and the kind of correction which we have seen in the stock, the huge shorts are built up on the counter, and even on a fundamental basis, whenever we see the positive numbers or any kind of comfort coming back on the stock, it swiftly moves back. So I won't be surprised to see the price moving back to a level of 1260 or so in this series, largely because of the short covering and because the good numbers are really very good. Mm-hmm. They have met the bottom line, they have met the asset quality. Mm-hmm. Minor deterioration of about 3 to 5 basis point is nothing that can be taken very well in its stride. So overall comfort on the results, and in fact I think that the results are better than what we have seen in case of Kotak, and in fact those results were also good, Kotak and HDFC Bank, but I will be more comfortable and happy with this number.
Mr. Dilsian, I'll come to you first. What would you be recommending?
See, two long call for the day. First on India Bull Real Estate, and with a day target of 74 and stop loss of 72. And second is again a long call on Union Bank with a day target of 165 and stop loss of 160. Because Union Bank, we have seen a huge beating before come dividend. It used to rule at 210, and even if you knock off 8 rupees dividend, probably this is the worst affected amongst the PSU banking stocks, and we have been seeing a huge short covering. So probably the long call can be kept as a positional view also, but for the remaining part of the day I have taken this at 165 as the target.
Mr. Tulsian, we are getting a lot of updates with regards to the PNGRB case, where it is where the government has told the Supreme Court that the PNGRB is not empowered to fix gas and petroleum product prices, and they can fix retail gas fuel prices under the PNGRB Act, and there is no provision in the PNGRB Act for fixing gas and fuel prices, and the government has filed an affidavit in the Supreme Court on the PNGRB and IGL case. Could you just take us through a couple of details that we should be watching out for on the IGL stock?
See, if you see the sequence of the developments happened, the IGL is having the favorable Delhi High Court order in their favor, against which the PNGRB has moved to the Supreme Court. Thereafter, Supreme Court has made all the concerned parties as the party to this suit, and now government, having filed this affidavit, clearly indicates that yes, this is positive for the companies like IGL and maybe the other gas distribution company. Now it is just a matter of time, because the multiple parties are now involved. The Supreme Court, it seems that today they have adjourned the hearing, but if you go by the sequences, this is seen very positive for the stock like IGL. Now the network tariff charges, which have been slashed by the PNGRB to the extent of 60-65%, will get strike down, and that will be seen quite positive. And if you see the performance of IGL, they have been posting an EPS of close to about 25 to 27 rupees, a good growth. They have a good presence in NCR region. So taking all this into account, once the final, you know, but sir, this volatility will continue to remain. Whenever the matter is get placed for hearing on the board of Supreme Court, you will see an upside. If it gets adjourned, you know, maybe for want of time at the Supreme Court for hearing the entire matter, again in this stock may correct. So if you take a longer view, it is likely that the Supreme Court is likely to deliver the judgment in favor of IGL, and that will be seen quite positive. And I have been maintaining my view, once that happens, the entire proceeding comes to an end, you can expect a price of 350 to 360 for IGL.
Mr. Tulsian, just quickly before we wrap up, a word on XSide. There have been multiple brokerage upgrades over there. Would you advise buying into it now?
See, Sonia, we discussed on the stock day before, and I said that I don't see stock moving beyond 140. And I maintain the same view, where I've said that probably after 140, we will see the profit booking starts coming in. Yes, the Q1 numbers have really been good, but I don't think that company will be able to post an EPS of more than 7 rupees for the FY14. And if you make that comparison, 17 time P multiple, Amara Raja is available at a P multiple of maybe 13 to 14 times. So yes, the 140 continues to remain as the resistance in my view in the next 3 to 4 months or so.
All right. Mr. Tulsian, in terms of Bajaj Auto, what would your expectation be, considering that the stock has been quite volatile in the past 3 months?
See, in fact, if you see the two things, one, ahead of numbers, I'm taking a cautious stance. I'm now not expecting the good numbers from the company. And second, the strike or the labor agitation going on. In spite of that, in fact, the stock has been holding quite strong. It has been it has not really breached 1850 and has been hovering at around 1900 or so. So probably I'm expecting that maybe the stock will see some correction after results, and I won't be surprised to see the share correcting to a level of about 1820, because you have very less chances of stock going up and moving maybe at a level of 1950, which is seen to be its resistance for whole of this series. So take the share with chances of correcting to about 1820 by tomorrow or maybe by Monday.
Mr. Tulsian, what about something like an Ajanta Pharma? Now that stock is going to, there was some news with regard to a bonus issue, but I was just looking at it valuation wise at the 1000 level plus, it's trading at 25 times its FY13 earnings. Is it expensive at these levels? And it has been an outperformer up 200% in this year itself.
That's right, Nigel. In fact, you don't get comfort by seeing such a sharp move, and in fact, I call it as the, you know, maybe the informed circles are playing into the stock. If you really see, probably it has moved by about maybe 400 rupees in this last 2-3 months. In fact, I have been giving a buying call on the stock when it used to rule any somewhere around 700 3-4 months back. But yes, after seeing such a hefty run, probably that is the, you know, mechanism of the informed circle who have been pulling the stock. I am not too enthused by the bonus. That is just a matter of arithmetical adjustments. Once, even if the bonus of 1-to-1 comes in, I don't think that is going to change the history of this company, because that can be considered, you know, in case of the other company. So I'll definitely be taking the cautious stance, in spite of knowing the fact that probably the stock can move to a level of 1250 or 1300, but it is very risky to remain invested in such stocks at such a high levels.